Alright, today we are going to learn graphical method x plus y is equal to 9 and x minus y is equal to 1. We will learn how to solve this by the graphical method. So first of all, we take this equation x plus y is equal to 9. Therefore, y is equal to 9 minus x. Now, we take the different values of x and y. Take any value of x and get the corresponding value of y. Try and get 3 points. 2 points are not sufficient to draw a graph. You must take 3 points. Suppose x is equal to, if I take x is equal to 4, then 9 minus 4 is 5. If I take x is equal to 3, 9 minus 3, 9 minus 3, or take 5, that would be better, higher. 9 minus 5 would be 4. And if I take 6, this would be 3. And therefore, this would be easier to draw. 4, 5, 5. 4 and 6, 3. Now take the second one. Take the second equation, x minus y is equal to 1. Minus y, 1 minus x, or y is 1 plus x. Again, take different values of x and get the corresponding values of y. Here x, y is equal to 1 plus x. So if I take x is equal to 1, I get 1 plus 1, 2. If 2, I get 3. And if I take 3, I get 4. So I get 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3 and 4. So I got 3 points here. If I take x is equal to 1, 1 plus 1, 2. If I take x is equal to 2, 2 plus 1, 3. X is equal to 3, 3 plus 1, 4. Now I've got this set of 3 points for this equation and set of 3 points for this equation. Now it's a question of plotting the graph. And to plot the graph, let us suppose this has to be done on the graph paper. Okay, this is your x-axis and y-axis. X, O, X dash. This is Y, O, Y dash. Now, divide this into two, take this green line. Here are two. Similarly here. And here on the y-axis. So this is your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now once the graph paper is ready, then you start plotting. Okay? 4 and 5. X is equal to 4. Y is equal to 5, right up here. Then after that, 5 and 4, x is equal to 5, y is equal to 4. Then x is equal to 6 and 3, x is equal to 6, y is equal to 3. So you get a line like this. Okay? And this is of course, x plus y is equal to 9. X plus y is equal to 9. Now we plot the other 1 and 2. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. The point is here. 2 and 3. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 3. The point is here. 3 and 4. X is equal to 3, y is equal to 4. Again, get a straight line. This way. And this is x minus y is equal to 1. X minus y is equal to 1. This is your point of intersection. And this represents the solution. Solution x, y is equal to, now you can see x is almost 3 and y seems to be 6. What are the value of, suppose this value is, suppose here, and this value is say here, okay, then it would be 3 and 6. But obviously it's not 3 and 6, okay, the value would be 5 and 4, okay, x is equal to 5 and 4, this value would be 5 and 4, but that is because I have not done exact value to get on the graph paper. Exact value on graph. Ok? you plot it properly and you will get exactly 5 and 4, whatever the value may be. In this case, it is 6 and 3, okay, but it is not really 6 and 3. But if you take a graph paper and plot it properly, you will get 5 and 4. Alright. Right. So in the same way, we are going to do one more where you have to do it by using graph. Let us suppose also equal to 5. Let us suppose it's like this. So I'm giving the first equation. 2x plus y is equal to 5. Y is equal to 5 minus 2x. X, y is equal to 5 minus 2x. 3 points. If I take x is equal to 2, okay, 2 2's are 4. So 5 minus 4 is 1. 2 and 1. If I take x is equal to 3, 3 2's are 6, I get minus 1. 3 and minus 1. And if I take x is equal to 4, 4 2's are 8, 5 minus 8, minus 2. I get 4 and minus 2. So I got 3 points now. Let us take a second equation. 3x minus y is equal to 5. Therefore, minus y is equal to 5 minus 3x. 5 minus 3x. So y is equal to minus 5 plus 3x. Sign to change the values. Change the sign. Now, again, take x. Y is equal to minus 5 plus 3x. Take 3 points. Okay? So if I take x is equal to 2, 3 2s are 6. So I get 2 and 1. If I take x is equal to 3, 3 3 is 9, minus 9, 9 minus 5 will be 4, so 3 and 4. If I take x is equal to 4, 4 3 is 12, 12 minus 5 will be 7, so I get 4 and 7. So now you can see 12 minus 7 will be 12 minus 5 will be 7, I got 1, 2 and 3 points, and then I simply plot them on the graph paper. Is your y o y dash. This is x o x dash. Hit points here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. This is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 0, minus 9. 8 points here also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Points here. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 6, minus 7, minus 8. Alright, so now we have prepared the x's, we have prepared the graph paper. Now we start plotting 2 and 1. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 1. Remember, this is not an exact graph paper. If you do it on your graph paper, you will find it exact. Now, this is 2 and 1, 3 and minus 1. X is equal to 3, y is equal to minus 1. The point is somewhere here. Then 4 and minus 1. X is equal to 4, y is equal to minus 3. The point is somewhere here. Alright. Now connect the line. Okay, just connect it. This is your point. This is your point and 9, this is your point. This is graph of 2x plus y is equal to 5. Take the other one, 2 and 1, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1, at the same point. 3 and 4, x is equal to 3, y is equal to 4, the point is here. Then 4 and 7, x is equal to 4, y is equal to 7, the point is here. Now you plot this line. And this is the point of intersection. Solution x, y, x t value 2, y t value 1, 2 and 1. And of course this is 3x minus y is equal to 5. The second equation, 3x minus y is equal to 5. So in the two lines, the point of intersection of the two lines gives the solution of the equations. Alright, for practice, I want you to practice this. Try this on the graph paper. I give you two questions which you must try in the same way on the graph paper. Number one, 5 and x minus y is equal to 1. Very simple one. Try them on the graph paper. 2x plus 3y is equal to 10. And 2x minus 3y is equal to minus 2. Write these two equations on the graph paper in the same way. Convert it into y form, take 3 points. You must take 3 points for both and then plot them on the graph paper. The point where they intersect each other, the two lines, is the solution. The solution is always written first x and then y, x and y. Okay, try this at home. And once you have done it, let me know whether you have done it or not, whether you have got the solution or not. You can reply on WhatsApp. Now I'm just taking one or two questions from the next topic. Equations that can be reduced to a linear equation in two variables. Alright, let's see this one. Equations that can be reduced to linear equations. Alright, now let's see this one. You see, let's take an example, you will get an idea. Suppose 1 upon x plus 1 upon y is equal to 2. And 1 upon x plus 2 upon y is equal to 3. I got this equation. I start like this. See, let 1 upon x be equal to a and 1 upon y be equal to b. Convert this into a and b. Therefore, I get a plus b is equal to 2 and this becomes a plus 2b is equal to 3. Now, I have to solve these two equations for a and b. So, I write a plus b is equal to 2, a plus 2b is equal to 3. Subtract it. Subtract. A minus A. B minus 2B is minus 2. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. So B is equal to 1. And can you take any one equation? A plus B is equal to 2. A is equal to 2 minus B. 2 minus 1. That is 1. Therefore, A is also equal to 1. But this is not the solution. We want the value of A and B. But 1 upon x is equal to a, rather 1 upon x is equal to a, x is equal to 1 upon a, x is equal to 1 upon a is 1, therefore x is equal to 1, and 1 upon y is equal to b. So y is equal to 1 upon b. B is also equal to 1. So y is equal to 1. And that was your solution. Always put x first. Is 1, 1. See, these are equations that can be reduced to linear equations in two variables. This equation doesn't look like a linear equation. This equation also doesn't look like a linear equation. But we have converted them into linear equations in two variables, a and b. Found the solution of a and b, and then found the value of x and y. Now let's try another one which is similar to this. Let's take another one. Okay. 2 upon x plus 3 upon y is equal to 2. And 2 upon x minus 3 upon y is equal to minus 1. Let us suppose now. Let 1 upon x be equal to a, and 1 upon y be equal to b. Therefore, this equation now becomes 2a plus 3b is equal to 2. And this equation becomes 2a minus 3b equal to minus 1. Now we must solve these two equations and get the value of a and b. The second one, 2a minus 3b is minus 1. So we subtract. When we subtract, change the sign. I'll change the sign. You can see this becomes plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus. This gets cancelled out. 3b plus 3b is 6b. 2 plus 1 is 3. So b is 3 upon 6, or b is equal to half. So I've got the value of b. And now take the other one. Any one equation you can take. 2a plus 3b is equal to 2. 2a plus 3b is equal to 2. Therefore, 2a is 2 minus 3b. That is 2 minus 3 into b. B is half. So 2 minus 3 upon 2. That is 2 plus 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. That is half. Or a is equal to, take 2 down, 1 upon 4. So I get the value of a and b. Now once I got a and b, okay? Now, simple. 1 upon x is equal to a. So x is equal to 1 upon a. X is equal to 1 upon a. A is 1 upon 4. Okay? 1 upon 4. So x is equal to 4. And 1 upon y is equal to b. So y is equal to 1 upon b. But b is equal to half. So y is equal to 1 upon half. So y becomes 2. And therefore, your solution x, y is equal to, now the value of x is 4, the value of y is 2. Now you can see these problems are quite easy. Just practice them again. Again, I am giving you a couple of problems for practice work. Similar type of problems. Just do it once in a notebook. You will see how easy it is. 1 upon x plus 1 upon y is equal to 6. And 2 upon x minus 3 upon y is equal to 10. Take the second one. 2 upon x plus 3 upon y is equal to 12. And 2 upon x minus 3 upon y is equal to 15. Now I want you to understand something here. Follow the same steps as I've done out here. Okay? Try and practice these two at home. Try to do them in your notebook. Send me what answers you got on WhatsApp so I know that you are trying to practice it. You can watch this video again and again so that you understand the method. you can rewind it, you can pause the video, you can fast forward it, but try and study the video carefully so you know the method. From tomorrow onwards, I'm going to start doing the exercise 3.1, 3.2, and so on. All right? For the time being, have a nice day.